Hey guys, how's it going? Brandon here with the review of the Blackberry Bold 9700. So let's talk about hardware and build quality. Build quality feels excellent, feels rock solid, doesn't feel plasticky whatsoever, and just feels nice to hold in the hand. Hardware wise, has a QWERTY keyboard on the front as long as the send menu, the new trackpad, back, and end key. Screen resolution is 360 by 480 with a 2.7 inch screen on the front. And it's really nice, clear, and crisp for watching movies or your basic internet surfing. At the top, you'll have your speaker and your LED notifications for when you receive messages, which comes in handy. At the top of the device, you'll have your lock key for locking the device and a play and pause for media and other applications. On the back of the device, you have your 3.2 megapixel camera, which autofocuses, and the LED flash and the speaker at the top. On the right side, you have your volume rockers, convenience key, which also, if you full click, will activate the camera application, which does really nice pictures, which I'll show you in the end of the video. On the left side, you have a 3.5mm headphone jack, micro USB convenience key, which you can set both of your convenience keys to do anything you want to. On the back of the device, you have a micro SD card slot, which is swappable while the device is on, and a large battery. Over using it for a month, I've noticed that I've got about 3 days of normal usage, which includes internet, messaging, and phone calling. So really nice battery. Under here you'll find the SIM card. Call quality is really nice and clear with the BlackBerry. Everything just works really nice. Using the keyboard is really nice and easy to adapt to. You'll learn how to use it in less than a day. It's so easy to use. What's new about the BlackBerries is they're implementing the new trackpad with all their newer models. It's really nice and easy to use. It's really smooth. You don't have to worry about if you have an old BlackBerry Pearl unit or the old BlackBerry with the trackball. You don't have to worry about it breaking or cleaning it out every time it gets dirty or anything like that. It's just overall smooth and a great experience to use. You can also turn this clicking sound off too. Well, that's for hardware. It feels rock solid in the hand, and I like a lot of the places where the buttons are. So let's talk about that. Like the apps and stuff. So media is great. I love media on BlackBerries. That's one of the reasons BlackBerries are my favorite. It does media really well. The songs are nice and organized. You just click and play, and you have the 3.5mm headphone jack on the side to listen to music. It has a 16GB card inside. It takes micro SD cards. And what's great about it, if you want to play music through the speaker, it's really nice and loud and clear. And you also have the play, pause, and mute at the top for easy access. Video on here is really nice with a clear screen. It's really bright and works great. Pictures on here works great. At the end of the video, I'll provide a sample of video quality and picture quality. What's really nice is the LED flash. You can use this with video too as your flashlight. It's nice and bright and just works flawlessly. Other applications on here include the BlackBerry App World, which isn't fully advanced as the Apple App Store. Or the Android App Store, but it definitely has a lot of the essential apps that you need, such as, let me just go to the download folder, such as the weather apps, eBay, Pandora. You guys see all the apps right here I have on the device. My camera won't focus, but PayPal, just a lot of the essential apps are there. not necessarily a lot of gaming apps, but definitely your basic games you'll have on here, such as Brick Breaker, Texas Hold'em, Klondike, Sudoku, etc., etc. Has built-in Wi-Fi and runs 3G and Edge. Also has GPS built-in. You have your basic IM applications such as AIM, Yahoo, Windows Live, and your browsing the internet on here is really nice and fast, especially with T-Mobile's network. It's pretty good. This phone goes it's on sale on AT&T and T-Mobile. T-Mobile for $130 with a $50 mail-in rebate and $200 on AT&T. But you need the smartphone plan, which also. So it's really easy to browse here. I'll give you a test of T-Mobile's 3G speed, which is pretty decent. Loading Gmail and everything. Just really nice to use. The BlackBerry browser is really nice to use. Except the browser messaging, really easy, nice and organized. That's what I really like about BlackBerry. Everything's just really smooth and runs well on this BlackBerry phone. It weighs about 4.3 ounces, ultimate media player, I think so. That's what I really like the BlackBerry. It just works. Everything works really great on the phone. Thanks for watching, guys. This is my review on the BlackBerry 9700. If you're hesitating to purchase, go ahead and purchase it. Try it out for 30 days. But that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys later.